Merry Christmas. Welcome to worship at Memorial United Methodist Church in Clovis, California. I'm Reverend Jeanette Saavedra, the pastor here at this congregation, and we are blessed to be able to worship together on this holy, holy evening, Christmas Eve. As we begin our worship together, I want to let you know that Memorial is a bilingual congregation, so all of the service has Hmong and English throughout, and I want you just to pick the words that you can read the best or tune your ear to the language that you recognize the best and just follow along and sing the songs boldly before God, remembering that worship is not a performance. Worship is each one of us as we open our hearts before God. And tonight, most especially, we invite the Christ child to come in, to be born anew in our hearts. We're going to be having a wonderful service together, lots of special music from people all around the country who are friends and our loved ones who are far from us. But through the wonders of technology, we're able to worship together this evening with them. And so as we enter into the service, I want to tell you that Jesus is for all the world. And so throughout the evening, as we have special music pieces, you're going to be able to see various images of the Holy Family, of the Madonna and Child, of the whole nativity scene, even of the night sky from all around the world to remind us that this birth is for everyone. So I invite you now, as we move into our worship, to take some time to center yourself, and then we'll go into our call to worship, and that'll be followed by lighting of the Advent wreath this evening by the Yang family, and then we'll have our opening hymn. So let us open our hearts before God now.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Sin and error pining till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn.
Us, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Usually at this time of the worship service on Christmas Eve, we would all have a candle, and we would take light from the Christ candle, and we would pass it from one candle to another, and we would see how the whole room is illuminated by this light. And we really wanted to bring that to you. We tried to do that with just my family, checking it out with the camera and my family, and let me tell you, it did not work at all. The camera is not the same as the human eye. It didn't, the symbolism was totally lost, and so we're not able to bring that to you tonight. But what I want to tell you is that even though we can't do that symbolism of taking the candles and passing light, you know, the light of Jesus is passed through our lives. And we don't have to actually be in contact with each other to share Jesus' love with one another, with our neighbors, with our community, with the world. So I want to invite you to find creative ways to share the light of Jesus in our world. This is the most important. It's important for the light to shine in you, but it's so important. It's so crucial to be certain that you allow the light to shine forth into the world so that others might see how amazing and wonderful is God, that they would be drawn to that light as we are, that the light of the love of God, the light of life, would shine for all people, would be in our hearts and through us, would bless all the world. And so this Christmas, please take time to share it with your loved ones, but find a way to share this love with people you've never even met, so that all might come to know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Welcome to the Yang family home. My name is Ying.
My name is Addie.
My name is Grace.
My name is Evelyn.
My name is Elijah.
My name is Michael.
I'm Joyce.
And Clara is behind the cameras. The Advent wreath is used to help us mark the weeks leading up to the celebration of Christmas.
Each week, we lit one of the color candles around the outside of the wreath, and tonight, Christmas Eve, we light the center white candle called the Christ candle.
The first candle is for hope. Hope to our family means being able to have faith and believe in the better things in life.
The second candle is joy. Joy to our family means spending time together and enjoying each other's company, as well as appreciating the little things we have in life and what God has given for us.
The third candle is for peace. Peace to our family means to live contently and in harmony with ourselves and those around us.
The fourth candle is for love. Love to our family means the willingness to accept differences and to love others unconditionally.
Tonight, we celebrate the birth of Christ. We light the center candle to honor Jesus, light of the world.
Jesus to our family means everything. He is hope, joy, peace, and love combined. He is the way and the truth. He is our friend, our Savior, and our moral compass.
From our family to all of you,
may this season be filled with love and good health.
Oh, hear the angels sing. Throughout the Christmas story, we hear how the angels brought good news to Mary, to Joseph, to Zechariah, to the shepherds. We're going to be turning to the scriptures now, beginning with the passage from Isaiah, where it talks about the people who sat in darkness, on them has light shined. Those who lived in the land of deep darkness, light is shining, right? For unto us a child is born. And so we place our little baby Jesus in the manger. And we'll hear the story of his birth. Let's join together in listening to the scriptures and the special music.
Mua yi tu mi tu lu yu hu bê chó lợ. Và chứ mua yi tu mi tu bu chó bê. Ha nư yu o tu gàng bê. Nư lùng bê hu o. Tu tuo sư kư mua tsu chi. Chứ tu mua phu chi. Văn lên chí tu kư nhó mong yi chi. Văn chứ tu.
His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness. From this time onward and forevermore, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration, and was taken while Quirinus was governor of Syria. Joseph also went to the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judah, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn.
Nhớ tha chẳng đỡ, mỗi giờ tôi này dù dàng, mà dù bố giờ dàng tỏ tế thảo trọng đủ. Tôi chú ý tôi tỉ chữ lưu cho bố, hả tôi chú tôi phụ trị kinh trọng á tô cho bố. Bố bóng xa hàng chạy cờ lê.
But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you born this day in the city of David, a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
Said the night wind to the little lamb, "Do you see what I see? Way up in the sky, a star dancing in the night with a tail as big as a kite, with shepherd boy. Do you hear what I hear? A song, high above the tree, with a voice as big as the sea. With a voice as big as the sea. Said the shepherd boy to the mighty king, do you know what I know?
Do you know what I know?
In your palace warm, mighty king, do you know what I know? The child shivers in the cold, let us bring him silver and gold. Let us bring him silver and gold. Said the king to the people everywhere, listen to what I say. Pray for peace, people everywhere.
So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph, and the child laying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what they had been told them about this child. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Yeah.
really, it is a holy night. What a wonderful worship service we have been experiencing together. I especially want to say how excited I am that Ka Hyo and Shua Feng read the scripture together tonight, and it's the first time I have ever heard her read scripture in worship. I am so thrilled to have that participation on this special night. It's time now to talk about our offerings and how we bring our offerings before God on this night when we've received the best gift ever. What gifts can we bring back to God? So we encourage people to strive for the biblical standard of tithing, and that's 10% of your income, to give that towards ministry for Jesus. And we appreciate all gifts that are given. And here at Memorial, it helps us to further the ministry of Jesus in our world. If you'd like to make a donation to our congregation, you can go to our website. We have donation buttons there. At the end of the service, there will be a little QR code you can scan. You can set it up through PayPal or with your bank. Whatever way you'd like to make a donation, that is wonderful. We appreciate that. If you're a member of a congregation in another community, I encourage you to support the ministry there so that your work can be helping the people right around you. We're a connectional church in the Methodist Church, and so part of what we give here will go all around the world. And this year, our Christmas offering will be divided between our worldwide mission, which is making such a huge difference, especially in this year of global pandemic, helping people to stay healthy and stay safe and find the saving love of Jesus all at the same time. And a part of it's going to go towards the North Fork Mono Indian Tribe as they are rebuilding and recovering from the fires that were in our foothills. So I encourage you, as God has blessed you, be a blessing to others and to give generously. We're going to be moving into the rest of our service for this evening, which is our final scripture passage and sharing the light of Jesus, and then our closing hymns and our postlude. And I want to invite you to join me tomorrow morning. We're going to have Christmas morning devotional. And I invite you, it'll be up on our website anytime after 6. You can find us on our website, on YouTube, and on Facebook. Merry Christmas. May God bless you.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it.
From the glory, he come from the glorious kingdom. He come from the glory, he come from the glorious kingdom. Oh yes, believer, oh yes, believer. He come from the glory, he come from the glorious kingdom. Come from the glory, he come from the glorious kingdom, he come from the glory, he come from the glorious kingdom. Oh yes, believer, oh yes, believer, he come from the glory, he come from the glorious kingdom. Shepherds came when the baby was born, and they say that his name was Jesus. He came from the glory, he come from the glorious kingdom. He come from the glory, he come from the glorious kingdom. Oh yes, believer, oh yes, believer, he come from
dumb. The wise men came where the baby was born. The wise men came where the baby was born. The wise men came where the baby was born. And they said that his name is Jesus. He come from the glory. He come from the glorious kingdom. He come from the glory. He come from the glorious kingdom. Oh, yes, believer. Oh, yes, believer. He come from the glory. He come from the glorious kingdom. Thank you.